Welcome back to part 4 of Rise from the Ashes. We're going to be exploring the entrance of the police department right now.
Yeah, I think this is the first time we've ever actually seen this building in the entire series.
We've been inside. We haven't actually seen the outside, I think.
Yeah.
Or maybe that's something different. Pass me, explain.
And we got Blue Badger standing there, creeping me out.
Learn to hate that Badger.
I always get excited when I come to the police station.
Why is that?
It just feels like I've jumped into a movie. Oh boy, here we go.
Huh? No, seriously, huh?
You know, with all the police and criminals.
Well, I don't know if this is all that exciting. Just saying.
Sure it is! Look at those two officers over there! They're probably talking about the latest bust. No.
Dot dot dot. Funny, I thought they were talking about the weather.
Ema, please.
They're actually gonna figure out what they're talking about now. Look, that patrolman is saluting the other guy. He must be a detective.
Then I said, hey, you do that, you're super get cold, buddy. That's hilarious, sir. I laughed so hard I cried.
Guess he wasn't saluting, he was wiping tears from his eyes.
They make a good pair.
Oh boy.
Yeah. I'm just examining everything because why not?
The banner here is announcing the crime fighting syndicate.
Campaign, whatever. Slogan.
I wonder if they'll be selling fingerprint sets.
I don't think it's that kind of campaign.
What family wouldn't want a set at home? It's good for finding out who snuck into cookie jars.
I think most families can figure that out without the extra help. Every time! Why?
Mr. Wright, do you know what patrol cars are painted black and white?
No idea. Why?
Well, I think they're designed after a panda. What?
A panda?
Not that I have scientific proof, it's just a theory.
Game theory. No, we're not going around with mine. Do you mind me asking how you came up with that theory?
It was when I was on a school trip, I saw a patrol car and it came to me. We had just been at the zoo, see?
Oh boy. What about zebras? Do they not have those at your zoo? Why do I bother?
She's making Maya seem smart now.
Nah. You know this face? Call 911.
You know, Mr. Wright, I've always thought something. I've never seen anyone who looked like the people in these posters. They hardly even look human.
That's probably a good thing. She has a point.
Jesus. I was wondering about that.
What? Dancing Blue Badger? It's my masterpiece. Gumshoe
what?
Made the
oh,
blue
God.
Gumshoe made the Blue Badger. Go figure. You made this, Gumshoe? Gee, 30 yards some designs. They just did my thing, pal.
Nice work.
It's battery powered, so it can go anywhere. There's no switch, so it just dances till the battery dies.
Poor Blue Badger. Fated to dance until he drops.
Learn to hate that stupid Badger.
Well, it's like the unofficial mascot of the franchise now.
No, there's a reason why you should hate that Badger. It's related to this case, for the record.
But he's still like the unofficial mascot of the franchise.
Learn to hate the Badger, please.
Fine! It's my attorney's badge.
You show this to me every time we meet. He's not wrong.
I wish I had a badge. Even an ID card would be nice.
Ugh. Wait. Speaking of ID cards, I found the detective's card, didn't I? There's your hint.
Ema, why don't you have an ID card? Aren't you in high school or something?
Should be.
What can you tell me about this?
Hey, pal. This is a detective's ID card. You can't just keep that. You gotta turn it into the police, man. It's people like you that get me into so much trouble all the time.
he's not exactly wrong. Meaning Detective Gumshoe must drop his card a lot.
Probably. Let's see. Bruce Goodman. Goodman. Sounds familiar. Nah, my mistake.
But don't you work together with him in criminal affairs? Whoa!
Oh, now I remember! Bruce Goodman! He's the victim!
That's what I thought.
Poor Gumshoe. This is why he's been kept us out of the loop.
Can you tell us more about him, Detective?
Yep, now that we've presented that, we can actually talk to him more about the case.
So, this ID card belonged to the victim?
Sure did. He was a detective, like myself. Chimney eyes. Detective Bruce Goodman.
Don't you think it's strange?
Yep.
I mean, why would the victim's ID card be lying on the ground where we found it?
I don't know, he probably dropped it. Well, Detective Goodman should have been at the police department yesterday. Don't you know? There was an evidence transfer for a case he handled 2 years ago. Don't you know?
Oh, no. Evidence transfer. Mr. Edgeworth mentioned that, too.
Indeed, O'Rooney.
But Detective Goodman was killed at the prosecutor's office.
Indeed he was. Too bad. Well, that's the thing. It's hard to say this, but, where is it that Chief Prosecutor Skye called him out there to the parking lot?
Oh, no. And Lana's confessing as much?
There's a story behind this, don't worry.
Oh, man, they are doing everything they can to say that she did it, aren't they?
Yes, they are. And trust me, you want to present this, too. That's the King of Prosecutor's Award that Mr. Edgeworth got yesterday.
Were you at the award ceremony, Detective?
Of course I was! I got an award for diligence myself.
Ah, congratulations.
Yay.
I was wondering, why is this award a shield? And why is it broken?
Oh, there's a reason. I'll tell you what it is later.
Damn it, Gumshoe!
Apparently he's forgotten. Yep, he forgot. But trust me when I say, it's very important that you keep that trophy with you. Both the badger and the trophy are important to this case.
Well, obviously, otherwise we wouldn't have you keep them as part of the evidence.
No, they're when I say that, I mean extremely.
Oh boy.
Yeah, that kind of important. I forget what I do here. It's been a while since I made this part.
Present the knife?
I don't think it's gonna do anything. Oh, you have to present the parking stub. I'm sorry. I have to correct myself. You can either present the knife or the stub, and you'll get the same scene.
Okay.
So either or, it doesn't matter. I mean, sure, of course someone else really did it. Someone who must have, must have a grudge against Mr. Edgeworth, of course!
The car and the knife do seem a little too well organized to be a coincidence.
I wouldn't say it. You know something? The actual perpetrator does not have a grudge against Edgeworth. They just needed more or less an excuse. But that's all I'll say.
Huh.
They need someone to take the fall.
Fair enough.
But yeah, that's as much as I'll spoil about this case. He's in a tough spot again.
Again?
Yeah, again. Don't you remember last year? Yeah, I said last year. It all started with the murder of that defense attorney, Hampton.
But Edgeworth was found innocent.
Oh, like that stops people. Listen now, there's always been rumors about Edgeworth. Forging evidence, making deals with witnesses, nothing outright, there are always whispered rumors. Ever since he was accused of murder, no one's whispering, they're practically shouting.
But But there's no evidence against him.
That stops absolutely nobody.
Edgeworth's always had unusually strong ties to the department higher-ups. It's only natural that people would be suspicious.
And boy, are they suspicious. Just wait till we get
I
to the
no
trial.
I had no idea he was under the gun. Oh, sure you did, Phoenix. Come on.
Just wait till we get to the trial. Oh, man.
This latest case has started a new rumor. People say the only reason he took this... People say the only reason he took this case is because he's aiming for the chief prosecutor position himself.
What?
That's a lie, by the way.
No shit.
I know the truth. Nobody wants to be the one who has to prosecute the chief prosecutor. Mr. Edgeworth is biting the bullet on this one. He's doing it for all of us. Dot, dot, dot. And that's all I know about that.
Oh, no.
I'm not officially on the case, you know.
Thank you.
Why aren't you handling the case, Detective Gumshoe? We met the guy who is... What was his name? The guy in the parking lot? That'd be Officer Marshall. He knows Marshall, too. He was appointed directly by the chief of police. Officer Marshall. Is he some kind of Wild West sheriff or something? No, Jake Marshall's just a regular officer. From West L.A. For a moment there, I wasn't sure.
Oh my god.
Look, pal, let me try to make things a little easier for you. Show them this, and they'll let you examine the crime scene. Maybe.
Damn it, Gumshoe! What do you mean, maybe?
I'll be surprised if this gets anywhere. Just like you're supposed to be there, and nobody will look at you twice.
Damn it, Gumshoe! Well,
before we leave,
he's giving us some good logical ways to getting around things.
Before we leave, let's examine our evidence.
Why?
Because this one that. Because there's some things that you normally wouldn't see if you didn't examine them. Like this little scribble on this introduction letter.
I did kind of notice it when I saw it.
Yeah, but if you examine it... Looky here! Looks like something's been erased. Maybe it was a letter or something to Detective Gumshoe. Let's see.
Annual bonus, $20. I think a couple of zeros are missing.
Nah, that sounds about right. At least in that detective's case.
Maybe I should rethink my career as an investigator. Poor Gumshoe.
You want to know
no wonder he lives on instant ramen.
You know what? The funny thing that I bring that up, in Apollo Justice, apparently amiss Skye is what who replaces Gumshoe.
Oh no.
That just makes it even funnier.
Capcom, why do you hate Gumshoe so much?
The only reason he even replaces Gumshoe is because Gumshoe isn't there at the time.
Well, the only other person that has worse luck than Gumshoe is Mary.
Yeah, and she's not... You mean Maggie?
Maggie, sorry.
Yeah, Maggie's not in this game either.
I only say that because at this point we've at least seen Maggie in my recordings.
Yeah. Maggie Beard is her name, and she's not really in this case. She's not in this case. Let's examine the blood on this knife.
This must be the victim's blood, right?
Either that, or Edgeworth cut himself peeling an apple.
What's Edgeworth doing with a knife like this anyway? Hey, maybe he spends his weekends roughing it up in the wild.
Oh no. Edgeworth? In the wild? I think my fruit-peeling theory is more likely.
Are you kidding? I always pictured him as an outdoorsman. Oh my god.
Now, there's a scary thought. Oh boy. I think it's about all the evidence we can examine right now. Except for this. There's not really much to examine, though. The only thing you can examine is the bottom side of it.
Oh.
Yeah. There's not much to reveal on that. Come on, pass me. Come on.
Look at it.
Come on.
Look at it!
Look at it! Look at it! Look at it!
Turn it around. Oh, wait.
Yep, it looks like it. Look at that. Hey, check it out. There's a metal plate here.
Huzzah.
It looks like the names of all the previous recipients are engraved on it.
Wow, one guy's listed a bunch of times.
Gee, I wonder who.
Bon Karma. Guess must be a foreigner.
Yeah, that's probably it.
Well, wherever he's from, he must have been an amazing prosecutor. Oh, no. I'd like to meet this Mr. Von Karma someday.
When she says it, his name does have that kind of ring to it. And Phoenix just sitting there with, like, all kinds of shifty eyes right now.
God damn it.
And that's about all we can look at. Now, let's go ahead and move on. Oh, yeah. We'll go into the underground parking lot in part 5.
Huzzah.
That way we'll just pretend Gumshoe's little slip, and then we'll be able to investigate.
Awesome.
Hopefully that actually helps. See you then.